This is one of my favorite images of my son, Marcus. He loves basketball, West Philadelphia, born and raised, you know, on the playgrounds. That's where he spent most of his days and all of that. And it just speaks to, you know, we work out a lot. We used to work out before COVID. We used to work out a lot. I just love this image of him. My name is Ken McFarlane. I'm an artist and activist based in West Philadelphia. The Root to the Fruit, Portraits of Black Fathers and Their Children, is a project that I started working on about 5 years ago. I saw a young man walking with his daughter as I was driving, and it spoke to me in a way that made me park my car, run over to him, and ask for a portrait. There was a conversation that came out of that interaction that sparked a need to create a larger body of work. There's a common notion, but you know, from I leave my house in the morning time until I come back in the evening, I see fathers interacting on different levels with their children. So there's a narrative, but I know a counter narrative, and he was proof and evidence of that counter narrative. Having my work at the Barnes was a wonderful experience, and I can take very little credit for it. The community carried me there. It's probably the sweetest thing that I've ever experienced as an artist, because it wasn't me trying to push the work, it was the community demanding that the work be seen and the conversation be held. My father was a photographer many, many years ago in Jamaica. I grew up hearing people tell me, you know, that my father made the first picture that they ever had of themselves. And I certainly didn't understand that as a child. I certainly didn't attach a great value to it. But over time, when I look back, I realized those were the seeds that were planted early, and they took time to bloom. Being community-based and community-driven, all of these photographs, I have a responsibility to how they are presented. And I'm in the community, so if I do something that they don't like, I'm gonna hear about it over and over again. And, you know, for the most part, my name is good in these streets. So all of my projects begin quite organically. So 52nd Street has a historical record in Philadelphia. It was once called the Golden Strip, a collection of black businesses from the north to the south. It has a great history that many of the elders know, but a lot of the younger people don't know. One time I was photographing a person by a bus stop. A crowd gathered, and I could feel someone's eyes on me. When I turned around to meet the eyes, someone said, "Who are you? What are you taking pictures for? Who are you taking pictures for?" And it was a barrage of questions, but I just took the last one, which was, "Who are you taking pictures for?" And I said, "Brother, I'm taking pictures for you." He said, "What? What are you talking about? You don't know me." I said, "Brother, do you remember what 52nd Street was 10 years ago, 15 years ago, yeah?" I said, "Do you remember when the elders talk about the Golden Strip, when there were black businesses from one side of 52nd Street to the other side?" He was like, "Yeah." And I said to him, I said, "Well, you mess around and your children or your grandchildren might not believe that black people ever lived on 52nd Street." And he took it in. And then he asked me to make his picture. I understand that I am part of a continuum of black image makers taking control of our own image. I understand that photography became popular in 1839 with the daguerreotype. And I know that black photographers were making images from 1840. And I also know that from the beginning of the medium, the black image was devalued. you know, the time old tale of the hunter and the lion. When the hunter tells a story, it doesn't sound like how it sounds when the lion tells a story. So we are lions, and we're gonna tell our story, and we're gonna tell our truth, and we're not waiting for anyone to lift us up and tell our own stories, because we can do it ourselves.